The more common name for this species is the crested porcupine. The adult crested porcupine has an average head and body length around 60 to 83 centimeters, 24 to 33 in long, discounting the tail, and weighs from 13 to 27 kilograms, 29 to 60 pounds. Almost the entire body is covered with bristles, which are either dark brown or black and rather coarse. This mammal is recognizable by the quills that run along the head, nape, and back that can be raised into a crest, hence the name crested porcupine. Also, some sturdier quills, which are about 35 centimeters, 14 in length, run along the sides and back half of the body. These sturdier quills are used, for the most part, for defense and are usually marked with light and dark bands which alternate. These are not firmly attached. This porcupine has a shorter tail which has rattle quills at the end. The rattle quills broaden at the terminal end and the broad portion is hollow with thin walls. When these quills are vibrated, they produce a hiss-like rattle. The front feet of the crested porcupine have four developed and clawed digits with a regressed thumb, the rear feet have five. The paws have naked and padded soles and have a plantigrade gait. The ears are external and both the eyes and ears are very small with long vibrissae on its head. The skull is specific in many ways. First, the infraorbital foramen is greatly enlarged, so portions of the masseter extend through it and attach from the frontal side surface of the snout. Second, the angular process is inflected on the lower jaw. And third, the nasal cavity is enlarged. Prominent pockets create enlarged areas of attachment for chewing muscles. Collarbones are very much reduced, and one incisor, one premolar and three molars are present in each quadrant. The male's penis is directed caudally when not erect. The crested porcupine is for the most part herbivorous, eating roots, bulbs, and leaves, but occasionally they do consume insects, small vertebrates, and carrion. To ingest calcium and sharpen incisors, they often gnaw on bones. These animals often travel long distances looking for food. They have high crown teeth that grind plant tissues, which are digested in the stomach, and the undigested fibers are retained in an enlarged appendix and anterior large intestine, where they are broken down by microorganisms. Most of what is known about reproduction in the crested porcupine comes from individuals in captivity. Usually, female crested porcupines have one litter every year. One or two very well-developed young are born in a chamber within the burrow that is usually lined with grass, after a 66-day gestation period, on average. The young weigh about 1,000 grams, 2.2 pounds, at birth, which is about 5% of the mother's weight. They leave the den after 1 week. At this time, the spines begin to harden. Crested porcupines reach adult weight at 1 to 2 years and are often sexually mature just before then. 4. Breeding occurs throughout the year.